Victory Ortigas is accepting donations for flood victims. Let's talk to Glenn Quizon, Kids Church pastor of Victory Ortigas. Good afternoon, Glenn.
Hi, good afternoon, TJ.
Well, Glenn, tell us about the support you're getting so far from, I guess, your church members and their friends as well, and what they're bringing to you right now.
We've been continually receiving different forms of donation, in cash and in kind since 2 days back. And up to the moment, we've been repacking them and setting them up for distribution to the different evacuation centers near Ortigas.
All right. And when you say repacking, do you have enough help so far in terms of manpower of packing the amount of goods that has been donated to you?
Yes. So far, volunteers have been coming in and out in shifts. And but of course, we would still be asking for other volunteers to come in to help us out, because we plan to continue this until Saturday.
All right. And when you distribute these goods that you have packed out, I guess one of the challenges sometimes for big organizations like you is to strategize properly with the DSWD as to where the best help is, or do you just go around the different areas and you ask them, do you need stuff, and do you just drop it off?
Normally, what we do is to keep in touch also with the different local government and also with our members in the different areas that are affected.
Okay.
We also keep ourselves updated by monitoring different Twitter accounts and Facebook accounts as well.
Okay. Well, I've seen tweets going around as well asking for people to donate goods and their services to Victory. What's it been like? I mean, one thing that's nice to marvel at times like these as well is our Bayanihan efforts, whether physically or even online. But what you've seen at your church, I mean, what are the kinds of people that go up there and help out? I mean, is it a range from young and old as well?
Yeah. I just want to tell you that Victory Ortigas is just really a part of the bigger Victory movement composed of different churches all over Metro Manila. Mm-hmm. And so far, we have had great success, because when times of crisis like this come, this is where we see the Bayanihan spirit come out, as you say. No? I think this is where our strength as a nation come out. Mm-hmm. No? We really respond to disaster very well, and we very resilient, no? To a point that the next day we're up and about, and that's what I like about the Filipinos.
Right. And I mean, are you as well receiving help from people who are not church members, which means they're actually getting messages from Facebook and Twitter that just get passed around already, and that just goes to show the strength of social media?
That's right, because it's not just all about our members helping out. No, different people from different walks of life would come in, would call, would donate, would give goods and stuff, no, to help out fellow Filipinos.
Well, one thing I can imagine that you guys are blessed with is a strategic location where it's not flooded. You are in Ortigas Center.
Yeah.
Similar, the only other one I know that's near you is UANP. So.
Yes.
At least people in the dry areas, in the Valle Verde areas, the Green Hills areas, they can go straight to you. Are those the kind of people that have been going up to you and donating goods so far?
Yes. As you said, no, our location is really very strategic. Most of the Victory centers are really in the malls.
Mm-hmm.
And the malls are open for a time to receive all the donations, and we were able to respond very well to the community around us.
Mm-hmm. So aside from physical help, what kind of goods are you still asking for people to keep giving? Because of course it doesn't end today, even though we're seeing sunlight.
Yeah.
It's going to take a few more days, sometimes even weeks, for people to go home from the relief centers.
Yeah, I think they need to continue to donate and give out clothes, bottled waters, crackers, and even lend out vehicles, you know, to help us deliver all the goods.
Mm-hmm.
We're talking about eco bags as well, so to help out in the environment. So instead of using plastic bags to repack all of these stuffs, we'd rather that we receive eco bags.
Mm-hmm.
So toiletries, flashlights, candles, and matches, and the like, of course.
Right. And we're looking at your website right now. Do you have the information that you just gave me? Is it all updated there as well? I mean, what are the kinds of goods that they can donate? Is it all there?
Yes. They just need to go to our official website, victory.org.ph, and click on the link Monsoon Relief.
Okay.
So they can also follow us through Facebook and Twitter. We have an account in Facebook, facebook.com/VictoryOrtigas and twitter.com/VictoryOrtigas.
All right. And you are located at the Robinson's Galleria, and you're open for all the mall hours, correct?
Yes, yes. But for today, we've been open since 10 in the morning up to 8:30 tonight.
All right. And I guess the convenience as well for being in the mall, people who don't have goods yet, they can just go there, buy it in the supermarket, and go straight up to you guys.
Exactly. That's that's what we've been seeing the whole day. Great. People coming in, bringing the grocery carts in with all the goods. That's right.
All right. Well, good to hear that. And, you know, bless all of you for doing the great work. And we hope that you continue to get the support from the community, whether you're members or not. But we need the buy-in effort. For sure, for quite a while. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much, TJ.
Thank you, Glenn Keyes, on our Victor Ortigas.